Hello everyone, good afternoon. I'm Prasoon Agrawal from EQ International Magazine, and today I'm here with Mr. Naveen Khandelwal, who is the Chief Investment and Strategy Officer at Hero Future Energies. Hi, Mr. Naveen.
Hi.
So, first of all, I would like to begin with a brief introduction about Hero Future Energies and what services does it offer for the Indian solar market.
Sure. So, Hero Future Energies is a renewable IPP, which is roughly 5 years old. This is a renewable energy arm of the Hero Group, which is a known brand name in the country. So in the last 5 years, we have been operating in three segments: wind, solar, and rooftop solar. And so far, we have done more than 1.2 gigawatt capacity as an installed capacity base. So this, what we are showing is a interactive digital wall, which talks about what we have done in the last 5 years and how we want to integrate renewable energy, sustainability, and technology to improve the life of the common man, and so that sustainable ecosystem develops. That while people consume energy, they need to increase the consumption of energy to improve the lifestyle. But while doing so, they should not procure or source energy from polluting sources, but from renewable sources. And good thing is, with the development of technology, which is integrated with the renewable energy generation, you get very, very good user interface, which gives you a sense of more engagement, more connectedness with the particular installation, and you start having different experience, unlike old days power plants, which used to be kind of not understood or used to be brick and mortar model.
As you were mentioning about this interactive technology which you have installed to showcase your project, shall we invite Mr. Vasu, who can explain this to our viewers?
Sure.
Vasu. So he's Vasu from Sapient, and he'll give an explanation about this interactive which they have created for HFE to explain this to explain their services. Over to you, Vasu.
So we've done this interactive installation using a technology called computer vision. It essentially means that we are making computers see things like a human being. So what it's doing is, it basically makes the computer see the light thrown from this torch, and that works as a trigger. So that's the essence of the technology used here. And we also combined it with a gaming engine, which is pretty much a very unique thing. It's not something too many people across the world are doing. The whole idea of doing this is because we are an innovation lab. We look towards developing things which are new, which are innovative. And the whole point behind working with HFE is because HFE as a brand is doing the same thing. They support innovation, they look into innovation, and they're looking to pioneer in the field, in their field, using innovation. So that's about the technology which has gone into it.
Vasu, can you please show this to our viewers once? We'll have a coverage of it. That's wonderful. So back to you, Naveen ji. I mean, just to have some closing comments, sir. Recently, sir, the industry has been, a very hot topic of talk in the industry has been the anti-dumping petition which has been filed in the Indian market. So what are your views on that particular thing?
So, of course, this thing is under consideration by government. So it's not appropriate on my part to give you the what will happen. But the point is, government has to strike a balance between the two objectives. One objective is to protect domestic manufacturing, which is linked to job creation. And second is not to take away choice of procurement from the IPPs, because if we are getting cheaper modules from outside India, that is resulting into lower cost of energy for the consumer. So I think all we would expect from government to do a kind of, instead of anti-dumping duty, maybe safeguard duty equivalent thing, which gives some protection to domestic manufacturers, but does not take away flexibility of procurement from us. That's number one. Number two, there is much better way in our view of doing the same, as government can allocate some capacity which is, let's say, offered by government from defense, from coal, from public sector undertakings, which are mandated to procure from domestic manufacturers instead of putting that as a restriction or condition on the IPPs. Because if our cost of procurement goes up, that will get reflected in the tariff. So overall cost of energy will go up. So without taking a firm position on either side, all we have to say is government needs to strike a balance between achieving both the objectives, that it should not sort of impact the plans of installing 175 gigawatt with always reducing cost of energy, and at the same time protect domestic manufacturing and jobs.
Those are some very interesting views, Naveen ji. Thank you so much for your time and this opportunity. Thank you so much.
Thank you.